So I think that's the first time I've ever directed the audience too. So in front of you, you will see all the 7th and 8th grade choirs. There is a 7th grade choir and 8th grade choir. Grade boys and the girls are separate. For this concert, since I am new to the program, I thought it would be great to just try a little bit of everything to see what's going to work the best for the rest of the year. Your faces. My name is Jennifer Nye, and I'm not new to teaching. This is my 24th year teaching, and most of my years of teaching have been a combination of junior high and high school, so it's not new to have that junior high voice, that male voice to work with and grow. And I come from Ortonville, not too far away from you. And like I said, I'm really excited for you just to hear the different varieties of the different sounds that you will hear from the different groups. It was great to be able to put them together. This group right here, if we would have had everybody, I think we're 13 kids out because of the flu virus, there would have been 128 of them. And so that's pretty exciting to think towards the future with all of those. So again, welcome to our concert. If you would look at the back of your program, I put a big plug in for having somebody play because I could not find accompanist to play for junior high for me, and so I'm playing for you tonight. And they're to the point right now where they could use their director, so if you're interested in being up for the concert.
Thank you.
graders come up and join today. It's always an interesting challenge finding a piece of boys' music when their voices are changing and they're not quite sure where they are. I always joke at every single concert, as soon as they come back from Christmas break, I always say, oh my, Santa gave you a voice change. Because they're going to come back. I get comfortable with them, and then they're going to come back, and then they're going to be here. It is really exciting. It is really hard for a guy to get up at this age and come and sing. So I just applaud all of these boys.
Thank you.
kind of interesting for these young people. I had an elementary concert on Friday, and then back-to-back this concert. So there was a lot of lost rehearsals for this concert on Friday. The reason that happened was that normally the two elementary teachers have came over and they have done fifth and sixth grade. So this year I'm doing all fifth grade and part of sixth grade. So part of the time when they would have had rehearsals was time when I was having a concert. So the transition part is always really tricky, especially if you're a new one. So the next up are going to be the ladies. They're going to each group of ladies, seventh and eighth grade, will be singing two songs, and then they'll sing two together.
Thank you.
She's also was the drummer on the boys' piece. She graciously said she would come and turn the pages for me because I'm trying to sing, play, word it to the kids, and direct it. And so turning the page, if I could beat that step out, was really great. So Aubrey was doing that for me. There's a lot of pressure on page turners. I had Brenna do it for the elementary concerts, and it's like stressful. I've been a page turner. That's almost worse sometimes than playing. You don't want to mess up for the company. So this is the eighth grade girls. When they sing Still, Still, Still for you, they're going to sing a version in the end of it in the German version. The Still, Still, Still. We don't have any Germans in here. Maybe a few? Thank you so much for coming to the junior high program. Following, they have a little transition here. Following this program at 7:30 is the high school program, and you do not have to hear me play for that. I have an accompanist for that. And so if you are sticking around for that, it should start right around 7:30. Thank you very much for coming tonight, and have a happy holidays and a Merry Christmas.
Mm-hmm.